The next 2 point we'll be looking at, we'll actually be massaging them together to create kind of a feedback loop, since the two channels that they're on passes from one to another. The first one we'll look at is just under the knee. If you want to find it, you feel on the outside part of the leg, the edge of the tibia. You follow it up until it starts to open like a triangle a little bit. So you have the triangle part on top. And just on the edge, on the angle here, you'll have the area that you can massage. You'll see that there's usually kind of two different perspectives on where it is. Some place it closer to the bones, some other school place it more on the muscle that's right next to it. As I said again, when you're using needle, you have to be extremely precise. Our fingers are much bigger, so we're covering the whole area as we'll be massaging it. For this one, we'll most likely be using the index finger to do it, simply because we'll have our leg across our lap so that it's easier to do both point together. The other point, which will be just above the ankle bone on the inside of the leg, so this time we place all four fingers together, placing the edge of the pinky on the top of the malleola, of the top of the bone of the ankle, bringing our thumb next to the index finger and then finding that sweet spot against the internal edge of the tibia. It's usually an area that's fairly sensitive. You might actually feel a bit of a dip in between the muscle if you rub up and down along the line of the tibia, so you kind of feel that little dip area. So I have one finger closer to the knee on the outside of my leg, and then my thumb that will be on the inside of my leg, just above my ankle bone, about the width of all my fingers together. The point that's just below the knee will have a strong effect on the digestive system, so all the space basically between the diaphragm and the belly button will help for the stomach, the intestine, the large intestine. And is a point that's been studied and demonstrated that its stimulation helps to produce more white blood cells. So stimulate the immune system is one of its main impact, as well as stimulating digestion, stimulating metabolism. So especially since we're less active sometime when we're stuck inside, we have a tendency to sit a little more. So this point will help us to activate the metabolism and give us a little more energy so that we can actually move and do some exercise inside our house. Massaging this point, what we'll do, again, this time the channel goes from the body, actually it starts in the face, go down the torso, down the outside of the leg to the middle toes. So what we're gonna do with the massage is that we will press, push down towards the finger and then release. Press on the point, feel that spongy layer just under the skin, push down and release, starting to create that downward wave towards the toe, and you might start to feel that your toes are kind of slightly tingly. And as you do that, you'll want to stimulate it for a little bit, a little longer, and then gradually with your thumb on the other point on the inside, you want to just keep a slight pressure so that you start to feel that spongy layer below the skin, but not press too much, because then you'll block the circulation. So you're basically listening almost like if you're taking a pulse of someone, where you want to feel the beat on their artery. If you press too strong, you're not going to feel anything. So you want to have your thumb just here feeling the wave that's passing under. And as you're doing the massage from the upper leg down towards the foot, that wave will go down and then naturally will start to come back and go up the leg. The lower point here is a great point for all the urogenital area, the one that's closer to the ankle. There is one little warning for pregnant women. Usually for acupuncture is a prohibited point. Since we're doing a very light massage, it's unlikely to create any issue. But just in case, if you're pregnant, don't massage it. Just do the one on the legs, they'll be fine. And so gradually, as you're massaging it down and pushing towards the toes, you'll start to feel that wave kind of coming back and pushing against your thumb. And once you're able to feel it, then you want to let it barely pass and then start to massage the other one. So we'll do kind of a 1-2. One starting with the point on the knee, pushing it down. And then once you feel the wave pass under your thumb, you'll do 2, pressing the thumb, pushing this time towards the knee to help the wave kind of come back up and releasing. So 1-2. And you'll want to do that 2 for a while until you catch the rhythm that feels right for you. This rhythm will be a bit different for everyone. So I'm just taking an average rhythm and you can feel if you need it to be a little faster or a little slower based on your sensations. So if this position is a little difficult for you to do, you can always just keep your leg up or down on the ground, bending forward, and do just one movement, one massage at a time. Find a comfortable position. Ideally, if you can do both together, you'll get very interesting stimulation, and if you can't, doing them separately is fine as well. As you're doing this, you might start to feel your stomach growling, some bubble moving around. That's a good sign that you're increasing the stimulation, the circulation of the digestive tract. Placing your leg down and taking a moment to enjoy the sensation between the leg that you just massaged, see how it feels, and compare it to the leg that was just waiting to receive its turn.